This is a presentation on the follow-up of the performance audit report on monitoring and reporting performance. We did the original audit in 2014 and looked at all 20 government departments. This follow-up report is report 3 for financial year 2016-17. Please note this is a summary of the report to Parliament. The full report can be read on our website. On behalf of Parliament, we follow up a selection of the recommendations we make through our reports to Parliament to promote agency accountability in progressing audit recommendations or undertaking suitable alternative actions. We also look at whether the underlying problems that led to our recommendations have been remedied. Monitoring and reporting performance, Report 18, 2013-14, is a significant report. It is important that government is aware and monitors whether it is effective, doing the right things to achieve the intended results, and efficient, doing things right to provide value for money. It is also important that its external reporting to the public is transparent and accountable. In our original report, we found the measures reported by most departments fell well short of being direct measures of the efficiency or effectiveness of the government services they delivered. Also, most departments could not clearly express how they transform inputs and outputs into outcomes in order to achieve their desired objectives. Queensland Treasury and the Department of the Premier and Cabinet have responsibility for the frameworks that guide external reporting for government departments. Queensland Treasury is responsible for the guidance for reporting financial performance, while the Department of the Premier and Cabinet is responsible for guidance on reporting non-financial performance. The Queensland Government Performance Management Framework sets out the mandatory requirements for performance management. A key requirement of the framework is for departments to report at least one standard of effectiveness and one standard of efficiency for each service area in their budget, the service delivery statement. Our original audit found that departments were not reporting on their effectiveness and/or efficiency in their service delivery statements for 72% of their spend. To better determine relevant and useful performance measures, departments can use a service logic approach to develop service logic models that represent how they transform the inputs, resources, dollars and people they receive into outputs and outcomes for the public. This is a better practice way for entities to ensure that the resources at their disposal are fully targeted at the activities that deliver the most value in achieving government policy objectives. Efficiency is measured by establishing the relationship between the value of the outputs produced and the cost of the inputs. This technical efficiency is typically measured as the cost per unit output. Effectiveness are the actual outcomes achieved. Departments typically measure service effectiveness as the effect on the service recipient. In our original audit, we found that departments that use service logic models were better able to develop measures of effectiveness and efficiency. In our original audit, we made 3 recommendations, 2 of which were accepted. We recommended that departments apply a service logic approach to group their services into common objectives and outcomes. We also recommended that central agencies update mandatory guidance to place further requirements on departments when reporting on material services, including reporting on the budget and measures of efficiency and effectiveness for each material service, and whole of government objectives and outcomes at portfolio or department level. Our third recommendation that departments be required to publish an audited performance statement in their annual report was not supported by central agencies due to the perceived cost and an alternative approach being considered as more effective. The Queensland Government has become more transparent and accountable for its performance by publicly reporting more outcome, efficiency and effectiveness measures than it did in 2013-14. However, more work is needed. Progress by some departments in applying a service logic approach to define their service areas has led to clearer expectations and targeted outcomes. Despite the improvement, there are still service areas that do not report how well departments use public resources to deliver outcomes. Although central agencies are progressively working with departments to improve performance measurement and reporting, they have not been effective as they could be. 2 years since their original audit, they have not finalised the guidance for non-financial performance measures, including the requirement for departments to include budget line items for each material service in the SDS. That means the public doesn't yet know whether service standards reported reflect the most material or highest cost services. Government is publicly reporting more outcome, efficiency and effectiveness measures than it did in 2013-14. But over half of departments still do not have at least one standard of efficiency and a standard of effectiveness for each of their material service areas. Departments need performance information to inform effective decision making and strengthen accountability. And the public needs to access relevant and reliable performance information to assess government progress against its intended outcomes. DPC has discouraged departments from including measures more relevant to whole-of-government objectives and outcomes in the SDS. However, central agencies have not established a way for departments to report effectively on the progress of whole-of-government objectives, so some departments are still including these measures in their SDS and in a variety of other reports. A public sector-wide report would consolidate reporting of individual department results rather than providing information in a multitude of ways and publications. Departments use a range of mechanisms to obtain assurance over published performance information. These include internal quality controls, such as the development and use of a data dictionary to ensure consistency and integrity of the data and management verification and approval of performance information and reporting. However, there is no independent scrutiny of these mechanisms to ensure that agencies report complete and accurate information that fairly represents performance. We found in a number of performance audits that controls over performance data are weak or absent. In some cases, departmental internal controls are not providing sufficient assurance that the reported performance adequately reflects actual performance. Thank you for listening. We trust this presentation has been of value. For more information on the issues, opportunities, and recommendations highlighted in this summary presentation, please see the full report, Follow Up on Monitoring and Reporting Performance, Report 3, 2016-17, on our website under Reports and Resources at qao.qld.gov.au.